India, in a recent major technological breakthrough, successfully tested an indigenously developed HSTDV, or Hypersonic Technology Demonstrator vehicle, powered by a Scramjet engine. This makes India one of the only four countries in the world beside the United States, Russia, and China to have managed achieving this feat. So, what is a Scramjet engine? And what makes it a breakthrough? Let's discuss. The HSTDV tested by India reached a top speed of Mach 6. This is around 7,400 kilometers per hour, which is 6 times the speed of sound. It was able to move up to an altitude of 32.5 kilometers in just 20 seconds. Besides its utility for long-range air missiles, it can also be used for launching satellites at low cost. This is not a weapon itself. Rather, it is being developed as a carrier vehicle for hypersonic and long-range cruise missiles. This is mounted on solid rocket boosters, which take it to the required speed of Mach 5 and an altitude of over 30,000 feet. The cruise vehicle is then ejected, and the Scramjet engine is ignited automatically. Scramjet engines are designed to combine the high efficiency of the turbojets and the fast speed of the rocket engines. Turbojets typically feature a rotating air compressor, powered by a turbine to obtain the air needed for burning the fuel to produce thrust. These are limited to the lower subsonic speeds. Rocket engines carry their own oxidizer, which makes them extremely bulky. Scramjets, on the other hand, directly intake the atmospheric oxygen into hypersonic speed without any rotating air compressors. This makes them lighter, faster, more efficient and cost-effective. These engines have three phases: compression, combustion and expansion. The hypersonic speed of these missiles is used to compress the air coming through a converging inlet instead of using rotating blades. Fuel is then mixed with the hot compressed air in the combustion chamber and ignited. The resulting jet of heated exhaust gas provides the forward propulsion for the hypersonic speed. An aircraft using this technology could dramatically reduce the time it takes to travel from one place to another, potentially putting any place on Earth within a 90-minute flight. As said by G. Satheesh Reddy, the chief of DRDO, this marks a technological breakthrough for India. The successful mission will enable us to develop many more critical technologies and pave the way for the future hypersonic vehicle development. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to the BrainVerse. Keep on learning.